All right, let's get savvy with Dubsado and use question mapping. So, what is question mapping? Well, question mapping is a way for you to pull information from one place and add it to another. So you're mapping it to another place. One of the ways we do this in Dubsado is with lead captures, questionnaires, contracts, and proposals. When you create one of those documents, you can create form fields just like this. And you can take that information and redirect some of it to the address book in Dubsado. For example, first name and last name. And website URL might be something I want to add to my client's address book. That way, I don't have to sift through different documents to find the information that I wanted. I can simply go to the address book and find everything I need for them in one place. So, I'm going to go first into templates and then to forms. And you can use whatever form you want to use. I'm in a lead capture. Then I'll hit edit. And my fields for first name and last name are here. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. In order to map these fields out, you need to use the short answer feature here. If you use the free response answer, you won't be able to map out the form fields. So use short answer and write your question. If you need to put a placeholder text inside the form field, you can. And then you can see here it says maps to. And I've selected to map it to the client first name. However, if you just hit that box, it'll drop down and you can choose the field you want the information to go to. Now, since I'm asking for the client's first name, it makes the most sense for me to map to the client first name in the address book. However, you can map to their address. Their alternative email contact and anything else in this drop-down box right here. I'm going to close out of that, hit save. And now I'm going to show you what it looks like on my website. So this is my contact form on my website. Here you can see the first and the last name here. So when they fill out this form and hit the submit button here, that information is automatically going to go to my address book in Dubsado. Okay, so now we're in the address book. And to get here, when you log into Dubsado, once again, you go over to the left side and you click address book. Then you select the client's name, and you'll be taken to a page that looks like this. Now, I have added this photo here, so you can disregard that. However, the information from the lead capture has been mapped to these fields here. So the first and last name were pulled from that lead capture as well as the email address. So you can see that all the information is in one place. If I ever need to contact the client, all I have to do is go to the address book to find that information. I don't need to go through a bunch of different documents to find where they wrote their contact information. And I hope you find it easy to follow the instructions in this video for when you're mapping out your questions. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to put them down below so that I can answer them. I will get back to you. So let me know how it goes. If you want to send a success message or a disaster message saying, no, this didn't work, let me know and I can help walk you through it. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll be sending more helpful tips your way with Dubsado freelancing and service-based business tips, including small business systems. And have a great day. I will see you guys soon. Bye.